The ocean is the dominant physical feature on our planet, covering more than 70% of the Earth's surface. The ocean makes the planet habitable, providing the oxygen we breathe, the rain that fills our aquifers, the seafood we eat, the medicines that heal our wounds, and the waves upon which we play. Technological advances allow us to research vast regions of the ocean. With new discoveries comes the potential to improve not only the economic well-being of our country, but also our quality of life.
The population of the Earth is about 6.5 billion people, and it's going to be 9 billion by 2050. That means that we're going to need to understand how to better use, plan, and understand our oceans for the future of the human species.
Our ocean is facing a lot of challenges. We use the ocean for a lot of things, for transportation, for recreation, for national security, for our food. And all of these are sometimes competing interests, and it's important for us to understand what services the ocean can provide, to know about our ecosystems, understand our ecosystems, and then be able to balance those sometimes competing uses for those resources.
One of the greatest benefits the ocean provides is perhaps the least appreciated and understood. Our ocean is the primary driver of our climate due to its immense size and capacity to retain and transfer heat and water, absorb carbon dioxide, and create oxygen.
95% of the heat in the ocean atmosphere system is in the top 30 feet of the ocean. So in many ways, the ocean is climate's flywheel. And that means that we've got to understand the transfer of heat across the ocean atmospheric interface. And that goes for the open ocean, the blue water ocean, but also the coastal zone, because that's where storm intensity is going to have a big impact from climate change.
One organization committed to studying the ocean and educating the public and our policymakers about the coastal sea is the Consortium for Ocean Leadership, a Washington, D.C. based nonprofit organization representing 95 of the leading public and private ocean research and education institutions, aquaria, and industries.
Ocean Leadership's mission is to shape the future of the field in ocean research and education. And we do that by managing programs, by coordinating programs, and by educating the bright young next generation. We do it with our university partners, we do it with federal agencies, and we do it with high schools and undergraduate schools in a very effective way.
Ocean Leadership manages more than $250 million a year in research programs for the federal government and private foundations.
We manage a number of science programs. The Census of Marine Life, for instance, gives us a feeling for what's in the ocean, what the changes are due to climate change, and they form a basis for the future. The Ocean Observatories Initiative, which is tied to that, along with the Scientific Ocean Drilling Program, gives us the past history of climate, and also we're measuring the climate changes due to temperature and salinity changes in the ocean as well.
Ocean Leadership also serves as the program office for the National Oceanographic Partnership Program, the Ocean Research and Resources Advisory Panel, and the Interagency Working Group on Ocean Observations. These programs help facilitate collaboration between federal agencies and provides guidance while working to achieve ocean science and technology priorities.
A very important role that we play is advocating on Capitol Hill for the importance of sound science to underpin the decisions that our legislators and decision makers are making with regard to issues that affect our daily lives.
Responsible ocean stewardship not only demands that we take actions now to wisely manage our seas, but that we prepare future generations to continue to participate in our understanding of how the ocean works. Successful ocean education consists of fostering a passion and understanding of the importance of the marine environment for the future of our species.
It's extremely important for us to instill a sense of responsibility and stewardship of our environment in general and our ocean environment in particular, and that's why we believe that ocean education is extremely important.
The Deep Earth Academy facilitates and develops programs and materials based on scientific ocean drilling expeditions and Earth system science to strengthen students' science, mathematics, and analytical skills.
It's a very important program in introducing students at what it's like to actually be at sea for a couple of months. And it's an interactive program where we actually take students and, in many cases, teachers out on the scientific ocean drilling vessel.
The Ocean Observatories Initiative is building and will operate an interactive, integrated ocean observing network to make sustained, long-term, and adaptive measurements in the ocean. The Integrated Ocean Drilling Program is an international research program that enables scientists to better understand past global climate, natural hazards, the evolution of the Earth, and deep sea and subsurface ecosystems. Ocean Leadership also manages the U.S. Science Support Program, which promotes U.S. scientist participation in the IODP. The Census of Marine Life is a large international program that systematically discovers, catalogs, and assesses the biodiversity of life in the ocean through a global network of more than 2,000 scientists in over 80 countries. The National Ocean Sciences Bowl is a program that prepares the next generation of marine scientists, policymakers, teachers, explorers, researchers, technicians, environmental advocates, and informed citizens.
The National Ocean Science Bowl, to me, is a classic example of how to inspire students and also to, if you will, place passion in their hearts for the ocean.
The mission of the NOSB is to enrich science teaching and learning through a high-profile national competition that increases high school students' knowledge of the ocean. Over 22,000 students and teachers throughout the nation have participated in NOSB.
The benefits that it provides are twofold, actually. It provides benefits to our students because it gives them the opportunity to learn about the oceans and then apply that knowledge to analyze, synthesize, and address real-world problems. But it provides a benefit to society because we're educating the next generation of ocean leaders and wise stewards of our environment.
Through its programs, the Consortium for Ocean Leadership helps students, teachers, elected officials, and the general public better understand the significance of the ocean, as well as the relevance and value of ocean research. Ocean Leadership shapes the future of ocean science and technology through discovery, understanding, and action. The Consortium for Ocean Leadership provides expertise in managing, coordinating, and facilitating scientific programs and partnerships, influencing sound ocean policy and education. To learn more about the Consortium for Ocean Leadership and its programs, visit oceanleadership.org.